in the previous video also we have seen the pronoun. What is pronoun? Actually, pronoun is the word which we use in the place of noun to replace the noun. It that word it's called pronoun. And pronoun also help us to avoid the repetition of noun. So let's see how many. There are also reflexive pronoun, relative pronoun, and infinitive pronoun. There are also three types of pronoun. First is reflexive, relative pronoun, and the last one is indefinite pronoun. So let's see first what is the reflexive pronoun. When we use the reflexive pronoun and what it works in the grammar in the pronoun. Reflexive pronoun we use to show that the subject and the object of the action is the same person. That means if any sentence is there, so the subject and object both will be the same person. That type, that is reflexive pronoun. So again I explain you what is the reflexive pronoun. Reflexive pronoun show the object and the subject both will be the same person. It is called reflexive pronoun. So to show that the subject and the object of the action is the same person is called reflexive pronoun. So let's see, for example, here and one thing also is there. Reflexive pronoun contains suffix. When reflexive pronoun contains suffix like say and say, and how to use it, we'll see it later. First, the suffix will be using there in the reflexive pronoun. For example, see, Varun looked himself in the mirror. This is our first example. Varun looked himself in the mirror. So here this Varun, this is subject, and here himself, this is object. So this himself is using for the Varun for this subject. So this subject and this object, this both is the same person. This both are the one person. That's why this himself is a reflexive pronoun. This himself is a reflexive pronoun, and you can see the suffix is there self, which I had told you before. The suffix we use in the reflexive pronoun like self and slaves. But when to use self, when the subject is singular, that time we use self, and when the subject will be plural, that time we use slaves. So see, Varun is the first third person and he is singular. So we have used here himself. When the subject is singular, that time we use the suffix self. And here Varun and himself, this both subject and object, both is the one person, both are the same person. That's why this himself is our reflexive adjective. Again, you see in the next example, this is also our example. He does his work by himself. Now see, this himself and this he. This both, this he is the third person, but this is the singular also. We can see, you should, before using say or say, you have to see whether the subject is singular or whether it is plural. So here this he does his work by himself. So this he and himself, this both person are same. This both are one person. This himself we use here for this third person he. That's why this he and himself, this both are the one person. This both are one person, and this himself we use here for he. So this himself is our reflexive pronoun. And we, here also we use this suffix self, because this is he is singular, that's why we have used here self. So when to use self and when to use ourselves, self and slaves. So if the subject is singular, I, this is first person I. If I will be there for in the subject, so you have to write myself, right? And if the subject is plural, that can be for ourselves. If you, this is the second person you, and here it's also you. But when we use you, but when we use you for the second person and it will be the singular, that time we use yourself. And if the subject is plural, that time we use yourselves. Right? Now the third person, this is the first person, this is our second person, and this is our third person. we. For I, what we are using? Myself. And for we are using ourselves. Now let's talk about the second person. This you, if it is singular, that time we will use yourself, and if it is plural, that time we use yourselves. Now let's talk about the third person, he, she, it. These all three are the third person. For he, we use himself. He, she, it, this all are the singular subject. So for the singular subject, for he will use himself, for she will use herself, and for it will use itself. And if the subject is in the third person, if the subject is plural, that time we use themselves. Right? That means how to identify the reflexive pronoun and how to use the reflexive pronoun. If any blank space is there, I just show you in the example. Now we have to fix here the reflexive pronoun. If this is given here, if the sentence is there and we have to fill this blank space, then which reflexive pronoun we should use there. So see, he does his work by. Now what to write here, which reflexive pronoun we should write here. So first we have to focus on the subject, whether the subject is feminine or masculine, or whether the subject is singular or plural. Now see, the he is the third person and this is singular and this is masculine. So for he, what we use? Himself. Right? So before writing the reflexive pronoun, you should know who is the subject, whether it is first person, second person or third person, and whether it is singular or plural. I hope guys you are getting this reflexive pronoun, and already you knew what is the pronoun. This is the type of the pronoun, reflexive, relative and infinite. So first you please write down this in 2 minutes. Let's see then relative pronoun. What is relative pronoun and how it works in the grammar and how to use it in the sentences. So you please note down this all things. Now before this we have seen what is reflexive pronoun. Now we will see what is the relative pronoun. Relative means the relation between two sentences. The relation between two sentences and when to use the relative pronoun we will see now. Relative pronoun refers to noun which comes before they. Refers to noun which comes before they in the same sentences. That means as the reflexive pronoun, the both reflexive subject and object both will be the in the same sentence. Like that only in the relative pronouns also, the relative pronoun it also we can find in the same sentence, is only in the one sentence. Right? Now which kind of the relative pronoun we can use in the sentences? So most commonly relative pronouns are who, which and that. Who, this who is the relative pronoun, whom is the relative pronoun, which is the relative pronoun and that is also relative pronoun. These are the most commonly we use the relative pronoun in the sentences. And the main most thing this relative pronoun help us to join the two sentences. That means this verb as a conjunction in the sentences. If two sentences are there and we have to join that sentence, then according to the subject, we use these relative pronouns as a conjunction and we can make a one sentence of the given two sentence, right? So this relative pronoun is work as a conjunction also to join the two sentences. Now the subject can be singular and plural. In the reflexive pronoun also, according to the subject, whether it is singular or whether it is plural, we can use the relative pronouns also. Who, whom, which and that. These four are main commonly used, the singular pronoun, sorry, the relative pronoun. Now, when to use who and when to use which and when to use that. Now see, if the subject is human being like any person, girl, boy, woman or whatever, that means human being. If the subject is person, human being, so for that we use who. If the subject is person, human being, for that we use who, right? This who relative pronoun we will use in the sentence when the subject is human being. So here also we just have to focus on the subject, whether it is human being or not human being or the other noun. Now in the which, when to use this which relative pronoun? It non-human being like animal, trees and other object. If the subject is not human being, that means the subject is not girl, boy or any person, and it would be the animals or trees and other object, that time we use which, right? Now that, when to use that? If the subject is both human and non-human, for both we can use that. For the human being we can use that and for the non-human being we can use that. These three relative pronouns we can use according to the subject, whether it is human being, whether it is animal, tree or extra non-living thing, or for that we use that we can use for both for human being also and for non-human being nouns for also. Now let's see in the examples. See, John is my neighbor. John is a writer. Now you can see the John is my neighbor. Full stop is there. That means this is the first sentence. This is our first sentence. Now John is a writer. This is the second sentence. I also said you before that relative pronoun verb as a conjunction, it help us to join the two sentences. So here we can see the two sentences, this one and this one. John is my neighbor. John is a writer. So John. Two times clear we use because these both are the separate sentences. Now we have to use the relative pronoun and we have to make one single sentence of this both sentence. Now, so what will be the answer? John, who is my neighbor, is a writer. John, who is my neighbor, is a writer. Which relative pronoun we have used here? Who. So who, because John is a human being, this is a person, this is a boy, so that's why we use here who. And who, I said you, who we use for the human being, according to the subject we can use who here. So the John is the boy, so that's why we use here who, right? So according, this is the human being, this is the boy, that's why we use here who. So who is a relative pronoun. Please note down this again. I explain you. When we use the relative pronoun to refer the noun which comes before them in the same sentences. And there are four common relative pronouns: who, which, and that. Now when to use this relative pronoun? If the subject is human being, that time we use who. And when the subject is animals, thing, non-human thing, that time we use which. And when the subject is both human being or non-human being, that time we use that, right? And even in the sentences also we have seen here, John is my neighbor. full stop. Now the second sentence is started here. John is a writer. So we have joined these two sentences by using who, because this John is a person. This is the third person and this is singular. This is human being. That's why we have used here who, and this is our relative pronoun. So student, please note down this in your notebook. Now it's time to go for indefinite pronoun. Before we have seen the reflexive pronoun and relative pronoun. Now this is indefinite pronoun. When to use the indefinite pronoun and what is the meaning of this indefinite? In the word only we can see indefinite means we cannot count it. It is uncountable. But when to use this indefinite pronoun in the sentences? And what kind of indefinite pronoun are there available in the sentences? So let's see. The indefinite pronoun refer to person or things in a general way. That means indefinite pronoun, it can be the person or it can be non-living thing or living thing. It can be human being or non-human being. For both we can use indefinite pronoun. It is not specified one person or thing. That means it is not confirmed. It is person or it is object. That means it is not confirmed it is girl, boy or whether it is non-living object. And for that the word is like body, things, work. Like this words we can use for the indefinite pronoun by using somebody, something, someone. From these sentences we can get this somebody, something, someone. This is not a confirmed, this is not a specific, and any name is not mentioned here. That means it can be anyone, it can be the third person which we haven't know it. Somebody, something, someone. That means it can be one person or many person. It is not confirmed, it is uncountable. And here also I have written it is exact count is not there. We cannot say the specific thing or specific person is there. So somebody, something, someone. We cannot guess there one person or two person. That means exact count is not there. It is uncountable or it is countable. So let's see how many indefinite pronouns are there. One, none, some, all, few, etc. We can use as an indefinite pronoun in the sentences. Again, I just underline for you this one. That means someone, anyone, none, somebody, someone, all, few, etc. That means this all are the not exact. It is not a specific. The person or things are not specific in indefinite pronoun. So one, none, some, all, few, etc. We can use as an indefinite pronoun. Now, for example, if your textbook example is not there, but I just have written here for your better knowledge. Many students are there in the class. Many students are there in the class, but someone can tell us the thing or someone can tell us what is happening. So here someone I have used, so this someone is indefinite pronoun, right? Here I have used someone for the many students. From the many students, someone, that means this can be the one, it can be a two person also. And here many and someone. For this many student, I use here someone, right? That means someone can tell us the thing, what is happening or what is not happening. So this someone is an indefinite pronoun. Now how to identify the indefinite pronoun? If you can see the word like someone, somebody, something, none, all, one, few, like this word, if you can see in the sentence, so you can just guess that is indefinite pronoun, right? With these sentences, with the help of this word, you can identify the indefinite pronoun. So here also in the sentence, someone is there, so we can guess that this is the indefinite pronoun. So this word will help you to identify the indefinite pronoun. So you please note down these all things in your notebook. Now the focus exercise is there in the textbook page number 70. If you have the textbook of GE, so please open the page number 70. The focus exercise there, we have to pick the correct relative pronouns to complete the sentences. So now we are going to solve these sentences and we are going to use the relative pronoun in and tick it. Two options are there for you. You have to use the relative pronoun only. In the beginning, what we have seen, there are four relative pronouns which work as a conjunction which help us to join the sentences. So there are four relative pronouns: who, we, and that. Right? So now this focus exercise is there. First one is the Golconda Fort is a famous monument in Hyderabad. The Golconda Fort. Two options are there, which and who is a famous monument is in Hyderabad. Now see, two options are there, two relative pronouns are there, which and who. But you should know when to use who and when to use which. We have seen who we use for the human being according to the subject. Now the Golconda Fort, this is not human being, this is the non-living thing and this is the object. So see, for human being only we use who. So for this, what we use? Which. So your answer will be which, because the subject is not human being. So we use which for the Golconda Fort. The Golconda Fort which is a famous monument, is in Hyderabad. Now the second sentence, the newspaper two options are there, that and who. Harish, reads app all in Bangla. Now see, the newspaper Harish reads are all in Bangla. Now the newspaper is, first you have to focus on the subject, whether it is living thing, it is whether it is human being or non-human being. And see, the newspaper, it is not human being. The who is there, we use who only when the subject is human being. That means we cannot use here who, we should use here which. The newspaper and that, you can see we use that for the human being or non-human being, for both we use that. Now the newspaper that Harish reads are all in Bengala. Now see the third sentence. Cafe Casablanca Now two options are there, two relative pronouns are there, who and which. Now according to the subject we have to pick the correct relative pronoun. Says, excellent, excellent cakes is near my house. Is near my house. Now see, the cafe Casablanca. Now this is the place name. This is the place name. This is not a human being. This is not non-human being. For non-human being, we use which. We cannot use here who, because who only we use when the subject is human being. So what will be our answer? Which. Cafe Casablanca, which sells excellent cakes in near my house. Now the fourth one is, the actor in options two and which. Two options are there. One, the National Award. Won the National Award last year. Has acted in this film. Now see, the actor won the National Award last year, has acted this film. Now the actor is, it is human being. The actor is human being. For human being, which relative pronoun we use? We use who. So the answer will be who. The actor who won the National Award last year has acted this film. So answer will be who. Now let's see the fifth sentence. I think you cannot be see the fifth sentence first. In just 2 minutes, you just note down this all. Because the fifth sentence will go very down, so I don't think you can see this. You please note down this all four sentences with correct answer. Then later we will see the fifth, sixth and seventh and eighth sentence. just rub this first one and we'll start with the fifth sentence. The architect now whom and which, these two options are there, which we made the other day. Is designing new house. Is designing new house. Now see the architect we made the other day is designing new house. This architect is human being. This architect is human being. For which we cannot use here which, because which we use for the non-living architect is the human being. For human being we can use this whom. So our answer will be whom. The architect whom we made the other day is designing the new house. Now the sixth sentence we'll see. The cousin, my cousin. Who options are who and whose. These two options are there, whom and whose star, I am driving will meet us here. My cousin car, I am driving, will meet us here. Now for cousin, this is also human being. For human being, now car, whose car? My cousin whose car I am driving will meet us here. So our answer will be here, whose. Now the second sentence we'll see. The TV program option is who and that. Sorry, John likes very is very interesting. Now see the TV program. This is human being? No. The TV program is not non-human being. The TV program and two options are there, who and that. For non-living thing, for non-human being, we use that. And who only we use for the human being. So our subject is not human being. So the TV program that John likes is very interesting. Right? So answer is that. Now our last one is 8th number sentence. The waiter two options are there, who and which. Sir us lunch where very nice. Now see the waiter served us lunch were very nice. Now the waiter is human being and for human being we use who. The waiter who served us lunch were very nice. So answer is who. So I hope you guys got how to use the relative pronoun and how to identify the relative pronoun, reflexive pronoun and indefinite pronoun. And the focus exercise 1 also we have completed now. The practice exercise is remaining. So in our next video we will complete this exercise which is given in the textbook. So till then, we'll meet soon in our next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.